Hello everyone. It is craft time. We have an order on baby Donald Duck. And so I normally, as you know, in the past, I normally glitter first and then put them together because it's faster that way. It saves time because you can glitter both at the same time and then put them together. Where if you put them together first, you glitter one side and you have to wait for it to dry and then glitter the other side. But this time I wanted to do a little glittering with you all. So I thought I would put them together and then we will glitter a little bit together so you can see how that, or what I do to glitter them together. Sometimes if they're more of an intricate, like have very many colors that back up to each other, sometimes I'll glitter in stages so they don't run or bleed into each other. Sorry, I saw a little something on this one. All right, and you can hear my voice. Of course, I have a cold from the kids. It's always nice when they get you sick after they're sick. All right, so let's get started on Baby Donald Duck, Baby Donald Duck. Once again, I have this always in my craft room to see where I want to position the starter stick peg that goes in so I know where he's gonna sit on the base. So we want it probably right there. I know you can't see it. Probably right there. Alright. So to line it up, I normally use the edge. Let me see if I can pull this out so you can see the edge a little bit. Yeah, I don't know if you're going to be able to see the edge. It's kind of far. I use the edge to line this up. Get my stick so I know it's going to be straight. I will try to eyeball it on the camera. I know you guys can't see that very well because it's white on white. Let's see if we can visually. Alright. Pig stick started. And because I didn't use the edging, I'm gonna turn it over, set it up, and make sure baby Donald is straight, and he's not. That should be good. I'm gonna check it. And make sure. Looks good. Alright. Put that back in. Move my pig aside. We have all our popsicle sticks. Just gonna get going. Sorry. I don't know why I put it so close to the back of the table this time. I need to set it up so it's closer to the front of the table where I actually do the work, right? Sorry, you're gonna hear a lot of me going, I don't mean to, sorry. I don't even know why I'm doing it. My nose isn't running. I have more congestion than anything. when you put the sticks on, you basically want to make sure that there's not going to be any major bends in the paper. So anything that you think is going to fold and bend, obviously I'm not done, like these little leg areas have a potential to bend. So you want to put one at least right there. We'll finish this triangle off. Triangles are the strongest when doing this, so if you can do it in a triangle, it will give it more strength. It's not always possible, but if it is, try. That is not enough glue. Actually, it probably is enough glue. I kind of over glue too. I over glue and over glitter. I want to make sure it's stable and strong. Which, this is hot glue. It's going to be fine. It will be stable and strong. I'm just going to probably put that piece there. And then probably a piece here and a piece there. A lot of times you'll see me use another stick to push it down so I don't get burnt with the hot glue. I also have these that you can put on, and it's silicone, and so you can use that as well. I don't know if I forget to have them. I just don't put them on. I don't know why I don't. Just a little. Boy, these are hard to cut today. I wonder if it's because I'm sick. Okay, so I have two of these on this order, but I'm going to put one together, and then on film, obviously I'm going to put both together, and then we'll glitter a little bit on camera. This is also another area, let me flip it over. This is right here, this is also another area that can get bent easily, so I do want to make sure I have some type of stabilization behind there. Obviously some type of stick, but it's a littler area, so I have this cut up stick that I'm gonna use. Sometimes I take the sticks I have, these crafting wood craft sticks, and I cut them in half lengthwise as well to get the smaller. See, like this one's already breaking, so I would probably cut this one and then make it into a smaller, thinner piece. And then they also sell these crafting sticks, which are thinner, that I use on some. Alright, so there's the back base. Ready to go. Just checking it out. Let's get the opposite side. That's the same side. Opposite side on. Some people are really good at just gluing this and it lines up perfectly. Other people, aka me, needs to line it up and hold it down still. Excuse me. Well, so I clip, I use these clips. I use the bigger clips because they hold securely. You can use paper clips. I just feel like those move around too much. So I'm getting it lined up, which I'm not doing a good job here. Sorry, hold on, let me take that off. That looks like it would be lined up on both sides. So I line it up. I put the clips on, and it's not lined up again. So let's see. Sorry, I might have to do it like this. I can see. Actually, that is lined up. Is it visually? Yes. Okay, yes, that's lined up. I'm going to put... I'm going to start from top to bottom. You can do bottom to top, however you want. I like to go top to bottom towards the stick. It's really personal preference. Alright. Here we go. Let me move all these out of the way. Alright. Sorry. Alright. So I'm just going to lift it up. And I do the same all the way across of where I'm going to stop. So I know I'm going to stop here. So we start with the sticks. Actually, I should stop here on a... Anytime there's a bend or a elbow-type curve or perpendicular 90-degree curve, should stop just a little bit past that. Because it makes it easier to start on the next, when it's already past that curve, the next glue. I'll show you. Okay, so press it down. Is that too close? Press it down so you're not going to see any of the sticks. I press it all the way together. Can you see it? There you go. It's still hot underneath. I can feel it. I press it down. Make sure it's all pressed. Looks like it's all pressed. Just checking, checking, checking. Okay. Alright. And then we take off all these clips. Once you get it started. Alright, and then we start just working our way down. We flip it up, do a little at a time. Now, when I flip it up, I don't know if you can see it this way. See how it's past this crease? And so it's easier to follow the line. Where if I would have done it right here... Sorry, right here before the crease. Then you can't get the glue gun in there to get a seal. God, this finger's in the way now. This seal right here. You can't get the glue gun in to get that sealed. Alright, I'm taking this off since we're not doing that. Alright. Oh, I gotta put another glue stick in. Hold on. Got it. Putting it in. Sounds alrighty. Alright, so you lift it up. Do the sticks first because the first thing that you glue is going to cool down first. And we do not want the glue to cool down on the sides first because then you have this rock solid glue And nothing's gonna stick to it if it's cooled down. Alright. Okay, lift it up. Make sure everything is together. Make sure I can't see the sticks. I'm pressing. Pressing. Press it down so the side hits the sticks. Now you notice I went across this way. I did not do the little tassel at the same time. I just went across and down to this seam. It just makes it easier to get it together before the glue dries, and then because you can lift this little tassel, and we'll do it. Oh. Alright. And then we squish. A little bit came out. You want, when it squishes out like this, you want it to dry just a little bit before you just wipe it right off. If you don't wait a little bit, it's going to be super hot. Super duper hot. And you'll burn yourself. Which we don't want. Now, at any time, remember when I said start with the glue on the stick and then work your way out, because if the glue dries before you are pressing down on the paper, then it doesn't stick. Well, there's a way around that. If for any reason it dries before you get to the sticking part, I don't even know how to say that. You can heat up the glue again and then just press it down. There's a couple ways to heat it back up. You can use a hairdryer, or you can use the bossing heat tool, which I have the bossing heat tool in my craft. It's on the wall. I have it hooked onto the wall, and I can just use that if that ever happens. But if you don't have one of those, if you don't do embossing, then you can just use a hairdryer, and you heat it up alongside on top of the paper, but be careful that you don't change the coloring of your paper. So you need to like keep it moving. I don't know if that makes any sense. Maybe I should show you guys. Alright. Let me know if that ever happens and you need me to show you how to do that. And I totally will show you how to get your glue to be gluey again. I'm gonna do like the bib right there. See, some of the glue is coming out of the bib, so I'm just waiting a minute. And then took the glue off. These baby Disney ones are so cute. I love doing these. They're so cute. They turn out adorable. Making sure that none of the glue is sticking. If any of the glue does stick to it, don't take it off. You know, try to get it off when it's still fresh. But seeing if there's any There's this eraser. Forgot the name of it. It's rubber, but it's a crafting eraser, and you can just go across the glue and it'll come off. You have to be careful though, once again, if you do it too much, the ink will come off the paper. So gentle, not too much. All right, we're getting there. Am I talking too much? Am I not talking enough? I'm trying to think of some useful hints or tips. Not hints, I guess tips. And when I do the glue, and I obviously do the sticks first, and then the outside, and then when I go to press it down, you notice that I am pressing it down on the side that I put glue on first, because obviously that side is gonna dry first before the side that I last put glue on. So I press it down on the side that I put the glue on first. Make sure it's all put together. Yeah. All right. Almost there, everybody. Woo woo! I'm trying to see if I could do this in pieces. Stick. Cute little foot. Boop. Okay, and then we can do it this way, like that. Alright, press it. Ah! See, it's hot even through the paper. Ooh, that was hot. Super hot. Ooh-wee. I have, I went through a lot of glue guns, the crafting glue guns at Michael's or Hobby Lobby. The volume that I use it is just insane. See, this one's the hot. And it's melting onto the table because I did too much. So I'm gonna let dry just a little bit before I press. Definitely did way too much on this. I want to get it up off the table after it cools a little bit, but not all the way. See, that way it comes up quickly. Except for this one spot right here. Sorry for that squeak. Okay, I think this might be cooled a little bit. So we can see it's coming out. Oh yeah, it's cooling. And then take it and just take it right off. Here might be a time to show you when it. If you do it before it cools all the way, it will be cool enough to be able to get it off with your fingers like this, and not dried enough to get it off, which is the key. All right. All right, and then all we have left to do is just this little foot. Let me get all the glue off my table into the garbage. And later I'm going to use this eraser and see how it just picks up the glue. I'll finish it later though. Take time to show you though. Make sure there's no glue on my piece. Alright, let's finish this cute little Donald gluing off. Make sure it's all together. And there we have baby Donald all glued together. Start the glittering in a moment. I'm just gonna put the other one together and I'll be back to glitter. Alright. Okay, we're back. And we're going to glitter the side up, let it dry, and then I will glitter that side up. Now, I have these glitter carrier holder thingies, and I have an extra one that I just pull the glitters that I'm going to be using for that project. So for this project, I'm going to use blue, black, white, orange. Forgot to pull a pink for his tongue. Here's a pink for his tongue. And orange and yellow. Okay, so I pulled them. I put them right here so I have them easy access. And when we glitter, we start from the inside out. That way, we do not ruin our glittering with our hand. Okay, so I'm gonna start with orange, which it looks like I don't have much orange left, so I might have to get more orange for the feet. And I just follow the line when glittering. If at all possible, you want to do long continuing lines or strokes or whatever you would like to call it. It does make the line look connected and cohesive. See, I'm already definitely going to have to pull another orange. And like I said before, I glue too much and I glitter a lot as well. I probably over glitter. I like sparkly things. You do not need to decorate yours at all if you don't want to. I like the way the glitter looks. That's probably why I glitter too much. But you don't have to glitter at all, or just a little bit, or nothing at all. Oh, this one's a new one. So I grabbed a new one. Look at, sometimes getting the new ones to start, there we go, can be difficult too. And then after the glitter dries, I put glossy accents and the Eyes by Ranger. Let me grab it and show you this glossy accent. All right. Moving on to the next step. This is Diamond for the white. I'm using Diamond this time. They like, I want to say 5 or 6 different whites. I saw that this one was low. So I did grab two more diamonds. And that is not straight. So if anything is not straight or it's not where you wanted it, you can just wipe it off before it dries. And I have wipies right here that will just take that right off. Love wipies. All right. Sorry. Turning Donald upside down so I can get a better angle without hitting the orange that I already did. This one is almost gone. I use Diamond a lot, so I have 2 that are almost gone. And then I pulled a new one, knowing that I had a lot of white on Donald Duck. Obviously, there's a lot of white on Donald Duck. Alright, I don't know if you can see the glitter coming to life. I'll also show you pictures when they're all done and dried. I feel like everything is in the way. I'm gonna move this over here. There we go. Black band. This might be a new one too. Cute little black band. We'll need the black again for the tassel. Blue. I find that it's also easier. I know it's personal preference, but it also seems easier to do the glittering before they're put together because it's on a flat surface. So right now, it is not on, like, my craft table is flat, but the Donald is not flat because it has sticks and glue all in between. Looks like there's a hole right there. I'm gonna cover that. And right here. Wow. In between it. So it's not on a flat surface. You have to take that into account as well. And the tassel. Anyways. I'm gonna try to get this one done and out. This order done and out because I have a couple of other orders, but I also have a I don't know, a demo or example or sample order that I need to get out to a client. And I did just the one thing I tell you all not to do. I thought I was getting rid of a piece of glue that was on the bib. And I just smeared all of the orange on his lip. But luckily, it was still extremely wet, so I could just wipe it off, and then we'll do it again. But that was a big no-no. I did a no-no. Luckily, it was still super wet. Let's see if we can get enough orange out of this one. And this is sometimes why I do the colors and phases as well. If it's a lot of glitter and a lot of colors right next to each other, like this isn't right next to each other, but like some rainbow colors next to each other, then I'll let the color dry before it goes. See, I swear it's still there. Maybe it's my imagination. That's great. Probably my imagination. It looks like there's a piece of glue, hair, the hairline glues that you get off of the hot glue guns. Looks like it's right there. Okay. So luckily that orange was fixable because it wasn't dry yet. This little bloopy thingy right here, that's kind of bugging me. I might have to fix that. Alright. Moving on. I grabbed the blue to do the blue, but I should do the white first. It's on the inside. So I'm going to do the white hand first. Maybe. Maybe not with this one, but maybe with. All right. Now the blue. Blue was really thin up there and then got really juicy down there. Let's see if we can keep it even keel. Now I have to watch my hand. Because we already did the tasseling and all this stuff. And we don't want to ruin it. Now here's an example of where once it dries, I will have to come back. But where, let's see where the white hand right here and the blue sleeve. I allotted the white hand, and I'm going to do it here too, but I also want the blue sleeve in blue, but they back up to each other. So that's something I will have to come back and do. Alright, on to back to the white to finish. How much more can we get out of this? That might be it for this one. Yeah. Put a fork in it. That one's done. And then I have this one that's kind of halfway done. More than almost halfway done. There, everyone. Almost there. Let's see if we can finish up the orange, or am I gonna have to go get another orange? Let's see. When you get to a lot of air bubbles that you see or hear, I don't know if you can hear it. The more air bubbles that you're gonna get with this means it's getting close to the end of the road with more air bubbles. Find a spot that does not have glitter to hold down as my secure. Alright. One section right here of white. The last bit of the white. And then let me grab the glossy accents to show you. Put it on the eyes. Alright, here's my glossy accents. That keeps it from clogging up. I noticed that if I just put the lid back on, that it does clog. So I use this sewing pin. I started out on my hand. I don't know why. I just do. And then normally I wait for the glitter to dry before doing this, because a lot of times it's in the middle and I've just glittered and I don't want my hands to get into the glitter. I'm trying to do it without putting my hand down. And then sometimes, like this Donald eye, I think both Donald eye are back up to the orange glitter. So I don't want there to be any issues either with the glitter. So I make sure I get the whole eye without going into the white area, which okay. And this other eye, which will be easier. Make sure I don't get into the glitter. Now it looks all milky and white right now, but it dries clear and it looks amazing. Alright, there's our Donald Duck. I will take a picture when he is completely dry, and it'll be at the end of this. Alright, thanks for watching. If you have any questions about these, just let me know below. Alright, talk to you later. Bye.